arena. Tense, nervous times for these players. They will both feel they have a wonderful opportunity here of progressing into the last 16. And they'll know who they will play in that last 16 should they get there. And they'll both fancy their chances then as well, because it's the Sri Lankan player, Niluku Gurunaratne, who came through surprisingly. Lively little players, Nguyen gets around the court so well. Kashyap can be a very powerful player. Expecting a close one here. Place in the last 16 of the London 2012 men's singles up for grabs. And already maybe a little taste of things to come with some tight net play. Kashyap taking the first point. It was a bit of a surprise earlier this year when they met in Switzerland, second round of the Swiss Open. Nguyen won very comfortably, 21-12, 21-8. That was when Kashyap was really struggling to make the Olympics. From Nguyen, and their players have been talking about the drift in the court that's been affected by the natural conditions, the fact that it's a big arena and the air conditioning as well, and it means the shuttle can be affected by a little bit of wind and it can drift, and it seems to drift long as Nguyen's playing it. Rally, and then the little drop shot just pushed wide by Kashyap, so Nguyen's off the mark. He was rocked a little, wasn't he, Nguyen, in his opening match against Yuhan Tan. Kashyap trying things rather simpler against the Belgian. When he was younger, his mum wasn't very happy with his choice of playing badminton. Nguyen wasn't considered a good job, he says. Doesn't get a good salary, but she realised pretty good how talented he was. He was national champion in Vietnam when he was just 19. The pause in play while Kashyap makes sure his shoelaces are tied up properly. Excellent cross-court smash, brilliantly recovered by Nguyen. Lovely placement though by the Indian, who started pretty well here. disciplines in total in the badminton this week. And the medals will be handed out over the weekend. Of course, we've got the men's singles here, women's singles, and then the doubles, women's, men's, and mixed. Excellent angle. He said he copied the star Kashyap of former world number one Sun Jun of China. Very attacking player, rally slow, then suddenly, as you saw there, injector, a little bit of pace. So the style of jumping is pretty similar too. Drifting wide. Excellent badminton. Well, that was a top class rally. Kashyap trying his best to mix it up. But all credit to Nguyen here, who stood up to the task. Well, if the early signs are anything, we're in for a treat here in a pretty tight game. Crowd enjoying that. Brilliant. Stunning. Well, this is a very nice way to start the day, isn't it? With badminton like this. Two players here determined to make the most of their opportunity. They will meet the Sri Lankan player, whoever wins, Niluka Garunaratne, who came through against the number 8 seed, Kenichi Targo. And, well, should they see off one another here, they'll fancy their chances against one of the surprise packages of the Olympics so far here in badminton. Just a little short there from Nguyen, and that's why Kashyap pounced with the smash. Could only watch and admire, couldn't he, Nguyen there? He is firing at the moment, Kashyap here. Well, the early signs are looking good from an Indian perspective here. Kashyap really is on great form. The little drop shot and then the little flick into the empty space. And the lead may only be 3 points, but Kashyap's playing some real high caliber badminton here right now. Of course, a long way to go in this. And in Nguyen, you've got a lively, wiry competitor who will fight for every point, cover every inch of the court. Oh. Nguyen's one of the players who has profited, if you like, from an Olympic grant. A lot of approval from his coach. And it must help for Nguyen that he knows that in the last three times these players have met that he has been the one who's had the upper hand. Oh, very good aggressive play from Kashyap there. Really good injection of pace in that rally. Found the mark again. Oh, we've seen some great displays of power from Kashyap that time, just guiding the shuttle right into the corner. Quickly pounced on that, and it's a really good interval lead for Kashyap Parupalli here. 11-6. And Nguyen at the moment knows he's got his work cut out here because the Indian is playing some terrific badminton.
Cầu mấy cầu kẹt ra sao mạnh dạng lớp gì em cứ ghiềm lưới ôm sát nó rồi ôm lưới rất nhanh chứ chưa cái cầu chậm lớp nhanh một cái.
Oh, great example here in this little slow mo of how the players stretch every last sinew in their body to try and reach the shuttle using all those muscles in their legs. Look at the height and the reach for that smash as well. I want to catch the shuttle at the optimum point. Here's the fastest racket sport around, badminton. Fastest smash recorded, 421 kilometers per hour. That's the Malaysian Tan Boon Hyung, who plays in the men's doubles. Well, I couldn't tell you what was being said to Nguyen during that interval by his coach, but the first point suggests that he wants him to be a bit more aggressive and try and attack Kashyap as much as he can. Easier said than done, though, but there you go. That time the smash is good. Kashyap looks questioningly towards the umpire. But stops a run of 4 points in a row for the Indian. A little bit of misjudgment by Nguyen there. I think was maybe hoping it would drop out rather than thinking it would. It was in by quite some distance. Was a little short, and he took it at the second time of asking there, Kashyap. Thank you. Oh, very clever. Well, feigned to go one way and then went the other there, Kashyap. It's all in the eyes. Yep, he looks like he's going to Nguyen's left, and he goes to the right. And as a result, the Vietnamese player is left flat-footed. Oh, that's unlucky. Just not happening for him at the moment, is it? And it's quite a gulf now in the scoreline in this opening game. 8 points the advantage now for Kashyap Parupalli of India. Well, he'll take every little break he can get, Nguyen, at the moment, to try and get back into this game. It hung, and then decided to drop over. That court going. Kashyap's away this time. Perfect badminton. That's all at the moment. It seems that Nguyen can do here. I mean, this is such dominance at the moment. Everything is coming off. Brilliant angle. And the head's dropped here from Nguyen. It's almost as if he's focusing on the next game. Giving up on this one. Kashyap makes a mistake. A rare one. And game points have already arrived for the Indian here. Well, what a brilliant opening game from Kashyap Parupalli, and he finished it in style. He was stylish throughout, though. Very dominant display, 21 points to 9. And the scoreline, well, pretty much says it all. Everything Kashyap touched turned to gold. He was quite magnificent. To be said there from his coach Pulela Gopichan. His badminton did all the talking. Plenty to talk about in the Nguyen camp, though. How does he turn this one around? It wasn't just the fact that he lost the first game, but the manner of the loss. 21-9. Turn it around against Yuhan Tan in the other match in Group D. Can he do it here against Kashyap Parupalli? But you have to say Kashyap is a superior player to the young Belgian. It's a very determined figure here this morning. New racket for the Indian, a little bit of a warm-up. Well, can Kashyap maintain this style? Can Nguyen somehow find a way of just getting through the barrier here? Well, what a terrific exchange at the start of the second game. It was wide from Kashyap, only just. Didn't miss the target by a long way this. But he won't mind. Obviously wants to win the point, but he won't mind. Again, he is dominating the rally. To the kind of start he was hoping for, taking the first couple of points here. Needs to get himself a good lead in this second game, otherwise he's going to be under real pressure. Well, his status, Kashyap, as top Indian player, was under threat. All came to a head at his National Open, the Indian Open. Faced match point against Bunsak Pudsana of Thailand. If he'd have lost, well, his Olympic dream would have been over. He won, and then, as he admitted himself, got lucky. Chen Jin gave him a walkover, and instead of J-Ramp, it was he who is here in London. Also showed some good form recently. Beat the world number three, Chen Long, in the Indonesian Open Super Series event in June. Super Series are the big events in badminton. Second only to the major championships, the World, the Olympics, the Asian Badminton Championship. Surely he can't win at such a canter here, Kashyap. We're surely going to see a fight back from Nguyen. Wrong-footed, the Vietnamese player, brilliantly there. No wonder the Indian coaches are applauding. Done that a couple of times now. To go one way, goes the other, and it just puts confusion in his opponent's mind as well. This is clever badminton, not only clever tactically, but also in terms of skill. It really is of a high class from the world number 21. In. Brilliant. It was tied under the net. Just lifted it over the head of Nguyen here, who's trying everything he can to stay in rallies. And from two love down in this second game, Kashyap now won five of the next 6 points. Hasn't done too much of that, has he, the Indian? Giving cheap points to his opponent. Gratefully received, mind you, for Nguyen's point of view. Well, his coach there, Pulela Gopichan, with his notebook out. Not sure too much of what he's written there, but it'll be very good, very good, very good so far. It'll just be positive notes, surely, that's being written. I haven't noticed too many flaws, maybe a couple of mistakes at the net, and that's all. Ah, that's more like it from Nguyen. Somehow, he's got to start playing his shots. Try and get on the front foot. Try and be the man in control of the rallies. Deceptive serve. That's a couple of really good points from the player from Vietnam. Reached the final of the Australian Open Grand Prix Gold event in April. You know, he's beaten some great players this year. Chen Long he beat in one of the Thomas Cup qualifiers. He's a highly rated player, but his back is against the wall here. Kashyap getting a touch of luck to level it up at 7-0. Very impressive indeed, and he's roaring in delight there, Kashyap. He played that point so well. And without a fear of repetition, you have to stand up and applaud this performance so far. Beating the world number 11 here, and I tell you what, given this form, he would beat some higher ranked players as well. Quickly gobbled that up. Nguyen can only watch in desperation. He knows he is rocked here. And I think if Kashyap just maintains this standard of badminton, I don't think there's anything the Vietnam player can do about it. Good lead at the interval for Kashyap Parupalli. The body language of Nguyen says it all. It's 11-7 and a game to the good for the Indian player. Well, there's life in the match, there's still hope, but Nguyen at the moment is a beaten man, beaten by the better player. Just hasn't been able to get going this morning, just hasn't been able to play the shots he wants because of the way the player at the other end of the court is hitting it. Staring defeat in the face, unless we are going to see a remarkable turnaround. Well, Just misjudged that, Kashyap. A little aberration from him. Thought this was heading out. And then realised correctly it was going in. But too late. Managed to get it back over, but lost the point as a result. Remedies things a bit. 12, 8. Hanging in at the moment, isn't it? Just by his fingernails. Best of three games, and of course if Kashyap wins this one, he will be through to the last 16. Bit of hope. Quickly extinguished. It's been so positive from Kashyap, so focused, so determined. Cries of come on. It's not as if he needed to G himself up. You half expect the man at the other end of the court to be screaming a little, but Nguyen at the moment is a pretty passive. Just 2 points in it. That's a case here of Nguyen having to try and change the course of this match. Try and knock this man out of his stride. Can't get a run of points together, can he? Bad shuttler here is putting on a terrific display. Nguyen here. He's staring defeat in the face, it would seem, against Kashyap. You can understand why just over a year ago Kashyap wasn't fully focused. The despair of what happened in his family. It was at a low point. I know victory here won't erase any of that, but well, I'm sure he will make his family very proud in the way that he is playing and performing. The man who almost didn't make the Olympics is now on the verge of a place in the last 16. He is 4 points away from victory. That's remarkable. Just dug it out and played a winner. 18. Romping home here, Kashyap. Ooh, just missed the line. A little bit of light relief for Nguyen. But it's merely prolonging the agony you feel. Yep, left it. And, mistaken. So 3 points in a row for Nguyen. It's going to take a hell of a run here to drag himself out of this mess. But while he's still uncooked, he's still got a way of trying to deal with things. It would be one of the most remarkable turnarounds if it happened, of course, though. Kashyap's just playing too well for that to happen. Looks too mentally strong. Look at that. And that's what we've seen in the 37 minutes these two players have been sparring. Kashyap landing blow after blow. Well, what a wonderful way to bring up match points. It has been a display of the highest order from Kashyap Parupalli. And now he is on the verge of progressing here at London 2012. He's been outthought, Nguyen here. Outfought, outplayed. It has been surprisingly one-sided. Magnificent, absolutely fantastic. Well, you can see the emotions here from Kashyap Parupalli, who makes it through to the last 16 of these London Olympics with a quite brilliant display here to see off Tien Minh Nguyen here in straight games. Almost flawless, that badminton. Big smile from his coaches. 21-9, 21-14, and it's Kashyap Parupalli through. Fitting he should win it with a smash
cross court like that.
Well, there's the final scoreline. As emphatic as it suggests, really. 21-9, 21-14. So Kashyap through to the last 16, where he'll meet Niluka Kurnaratne of Sri Lanka. Men's singles action in Group A from the group play stage here. And it's a straight knockout, really, because we've got Taufik Hidayat of Indonesia and Pablo Abian of Spain, who have both won their opening matches. Winner takes all. Indonesian against the Spaniard, the former Olympic champion, against a player from Spain who is trying to break down the barrier as far as badminton in his country is concerned.